Hello and welcome to the Concept Artist Podcast, interviewing up-and-coming concept artists to learn what it's like entering the industry today. Hugo Lambert is an intern concept artist currently working at Behaviour Interactive. He has an impressive ability to suggest detail with minimal brushstrokes. He has also helped to design parts of two DLC-sided Skyrim mods, Project Cathaqui, The Fractured Isle, and TES, Valenwood. Welcome to the show!
Hey, thank you. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for being here. So the first initial question that I like to ask folks when they come on is, what would you say is the thing that separates a concept artist from something like an illustrator or a map painter?
That's a really good question. Actually, I have an answer. I know I heard some podcasts before. Many concept artists weren't sure either. I think my take on this is that concept art versus illustration is pretty much, on some cases, the result is pretty much the same, but it's when it comes in the production of a game, for example, that differ between each other. So concept art is in the pre-production phase. It's about the design. And maybe some concept arts might look like illustration. It's totally true. You could not tell the difference. But just because it is done in the mindset to iterate on a design, change everything. Like an illustration is something that is, I would call a promotional art. It's something that the player, if it's a video game, will see. But concept art, no one will see it unless it is shown in a hard book. And when you do an illustration, most of the time, I want to say every time, there was a concept art that came first. So that's the main thing that separate each other.
So concept art is more of the beginning step of the process.
Yes. You have to iterate on the pose and the lighting and all when you do an illustration, but in general, the design is already done, is already decided.
So when it comes to your own art, where would you say that you find the most valuable feedback? I feel like you can definitely tell us a lot about that from your internship currently.
Yes, I do learn a lot, but actually, in my internship, I'm in a division of behavior where I'm the only concept artist.
Oh.
So this division didn't have a concept artist before, so it's new to them. So in terms of concept art critiques, I don't have another senior with me. At least I have to go search for feedbacks in another division, which is something I haven't done yet. But we do work in collaboration with another studio on the project we are currently working on. And there is some concept artists there, but it's like the communication is not as good as if they were in the same team as me at Behaviour. But I do learn a lot of things just by having a lot of assignments that puts me in outside of my comfort zone. I learn a lot by that.
So you're in a little bit of uncharted territory right now, huh?
Yeah, a little bit.
But I feel like learning on the fly like that must be a bit of an adventure as well.
Yes, it is. It's stressful at the beginning, but I start to take the beat, take the rhythm.
Well, that's good to hear. I hope that it is a positive experience even through the stress.
It's a super positive experience.
Wonderful. So through this internship, portfolio is obviously incredibly important. When did you start focusing on building up your portfolio? And what would you say was your process for deeming pieces for it to be acceptable for your standards to put into your portfolio?
Actually, there's no precise moment when I start doing my portfolio. Well, at least I think the oldest piece on my portfolio is from a year ago in September, I think. But I was just doing an artwork. When I finished it, I was like, damn, it looks good. I will put it in my portfolio. And it was pretty much the same process for many of the portfolio pieces that I have. But I do have some portfolio pieces that I did really in the mindset of doing a portfolio piece. The portfolio pieces that I wanted to create, especially for my portfolio, like really portfolio-wise, were all things that I was not or maybe less comfortable to do, just to have a more versatile portfolio to reinforce what I already had.
Ah, gotcha. All right. Having that growth mindset with one's portfolio, I feel like is very healthy for all artists, no matter what stage they're at.
Yeah, especially if you draw what you like, you're always better at drawing what you like.
Exactly. And when it comes to your portfolio, what did you have in it when you started your internship?
I had something like 5 to 16 pieces of exterior environment, of fantasy and sci-fi, interior environments, some vehicle designs / robots, and 2 character designs, just to say I can design characters as well, and a 3D project that showcase my animation skills, 3D skills, and lighting, etc., just to say that I'm also fully formed 3D generalist. It's usually a good setting point on top of being a good concept artist. Knowing all the 3D softwares usually looks good in a portfolio.
Oh, I couldn't agree more. I keep hearing, and I completely agree with the sentiment, that 3D is very key.
Yeah, it's super powerful.
And looking through your portfolio on ArtStation, it is very well-rounded. I'm personally a big fan of the Crusader tank. I think that that's an idea that I never would have thought of, and I think that's really fun.
This one was a 3D blackout at the beginning. So I think that was the first piece I ever used 3D as a base.
Ah, what program did you use, if I may ask?
I use Autodesk Maya because at my college program, they give a student license.
Nice.
Otherwise, I would have used Blender, of course.
Oh, always take advantage of the student licenses as you can.
Yes. Actually, I think I don't have it anymore, so I cannot use Maya at home. That's funny.
Well, that's what Blender's for.
Yes.
So, jumping back to the subject of your internship, how old were you when you really started to kind of dip your toes into the industry?
I was 20, and to be more precise, I'm actually 21 since a week.
Happy birthday!
Thank you!
And how did you go about finding out about your internship? Were you looking around for places to intern, or did you find out about it through your school?
When I finished college, I decided to not go to university, because there's no concept art program. The concept art programs that are available are from private schools, and they are pretty expensive. I didn't have the money. So I was just in a mood, just in the mindset of building a portfolio until I find a job. And I was like, maybe it will be in 1 year, 2 years, but that was my plan.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, it took 3 months. If only I knew 3 weeks ago that I will find a job 3 weeks later, I would have been way less stressed about it. I really thought it would take like 2 years minimum. Actually, it went quite fast. I just found an ad on LinkedIn about an internship, and I was super surprised because I didn't know internships and concept art were a thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you have a creative impact on the projects you work on. It's a lot of responsibility that you put on someone that have absolutely no experience.
Oh, yeah.
So, yes, I submit my portfolio and my CV and all, and I get the interview and I get the job, and I still don't believe it. And I'm actually really lucky, I think.
Well, I encourage you to not let imposter syndrome take over as well. I feel like that's something all of us artists struggle with to a degree.
Oh, yes, I do have it. I do have it right now.
How many places had you applied to before that? Or was this kind of the lucky one that you saw the listing and went, yep, that one?
4 months before the ad that gave me a job, there was another ad on LinkedIn from a Behaviour again for another internship in concept art. I tried, it didn't work this time, but it was okay with me because college wasn't even done yet, and I had to do a final project and all. I was quite busy.
Ah, yep.
So I was like, oh, let's go, let's take a chance. It didn't work. Well, that's fine. But the second ad was the good one, so quite happy about it.
When they contacted you back, did you have an interview with them? And if so, what was the interview process like?
Yes, the HR reached me for the interview. That's what I did. I did interview. I met the creative director, which was super cool, by the way. It was the less stressful interview I ever had in my life. It was basically just a huge vibe check because they already saw the portfolio. You don't have to talk over your portfolio to see if the art is great or not. Not saying that this is the case for every interview, but in my case, it was really just about sizing if the person will fit the team in a way that, is it just a great human being? Are you kind? I don't know. Do you have a good vibe?
Yeah.
If you're annoying, I guess you could fail this interview, but I'm pretty sure if you have the interview, you will have the job.
Yeah. Kind of see if you'll mesh well. Did you have any expectations when you went into the internship, or were you kind of going in blind? Did you really know it was going to happen on your first day?
Absolutely not. I was hoping to be merged with another senior concept artist so he could taught me how to do concept art at Behaviour, etc. What is their pipeline? But actually, like I said earlier, I was the first concept artist ever on this division. So pretty much, I was already the concept art scientist. If you want to talk about concept art, go see Hugo. He knows everything. So that was not what I thought it will be, but it turned out pretty well.
Well, I'm glad that you've been able to have a little adventure with it as well.
Yes.
And what does your average day look like? Are you working remote right now? Are you in office? What's the situation?
Actually, you have the option to work at home and at the studio.
Mm.
Basically, you choose which day of the week you want to come at the studio to work. But if you want to work all the week at home, you can do it. But I decided to always go to the studio because I prefer not being in my room for too long. It's a super great looking environment. I want to benefit of this crazy environment because it's a lot different than school. It's actually, first, the food is so good. Wow. That's something.
That is always a plus.
Yes. But also the graphic display they gave me to draw is like 2 times the size of the graphic display I have at home. I don't want to work in remote. At studio, it's just better in my case.
Well, that makes complete sense. I understand completely. What does kind of your average day look like? What kind of days of the week do you have? Is it a 9-to-5 situation, Monday through Friday?
I choose my schedule. They want me to be available from 10 a.m. to, I think, 4 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
And outside of that, I manage my hours like I want. I have to do 7-to-5 hours a day.
Mm-hmm.
But I can start at 8 a.m. or at 10 a.m. if I want. It doesn't matter. As long as at 10 a.m. until 4 p.m. I am available for a meeting or whatever, it's okay. So I can finish work at like 6 p.m. if I start late, and it will be fine.
Nice. Do you have kind of meeting check-ins with any of the other staff or?
Yes. So at the beginning of the day, We always have a meeting, a short meeting, like 15 minutes, not more, where I do a turnaround, and everybody says what he's gonna do for the day, and if he has question about what he/she has to do for the day. And other than that, the other meetings, sometimes you have three in a day, sometimes you don't have anyone. But the meeting at the beginning of the day is always there just to ensure that you're doing the right thing.
Good. Kind of keep things organized.
Yes, exactly.
Wonderful. And you greenlit these questions before, but I just wanted to reiterate that you can always decline. One of the major difficulties that a lot of aspiring concept artists face, and a lot of artists in general, is not knowing what their value is. With your internship and with your work outside, would you be comfortable at all discussing pay and benefits?
Yes, absolutely. But in terms of benefits, I should reread the contract because I don't remember really well, but I remember the salary at least, because at the moment I'm still an intern, mm-hmm. So I don't have benefits. I only have a salary, which makes sense. A salary of $36,000 per year, which is the equivalent, I think, of $18.5 per hour. So that's, in my opinion, that's pretty great for an internship, because it's a debate if internship should be paid or not, and I'm paid, but like quite well for an internship. But at the same time, the work I do as an intern is the equivalent of the work I would do as a junior. So I'm theoretically underpaid, but that's fine because I already signed up the next contract that will start December 4th, where I will be officially a full-time concept artist at Behaviour.
Congratulations!
Thank you. I'm really happy about it.
That's wonderful. Well, thank you for that insight. And how much, I'm not sure if you do commissions outside of your work right now. Do you?
I did some in September and August, but I stopped because the work I did at the studio, I have enough work. When I come home, I just want to draw for myself. So I don't do commissions since October.
Makes sense. Be able to come home and do something for you for a little bit.
Yeah, because I draw a lot for others, but sometimes I want to have my own personal projects.
Oh yeah, and I think it's healthy for artists to have their own personal projects to work on as well.
Yes, absolutely.
What is cost of living where you are?
I live in Montreal, so it will be in Canadian dollar. I pay $500 in rent, $90 for transit, and food, it's the average, I would say.
So you mentioned just before working on pieces for yourself. Do you have any outside pieces that you're currently working on? Is that kind of how you spend a lot of your time when you're off work, is working on personal projects?
I have to admit, when I landed the job, I had like a down when I stopped drawing and stopped doing personal projects, because all the stress just disappeared. I was like, damn, I can play video game without feeling guilty of doing this instead of working on my portfolio. So I must admit, I played a lot video games lately, but now I restart feeling guilty because I feel like I can, and it's absolutely normal, but I feel like I can push myself further to enhance my drawing skill. And enough video games, I'm back on my personal projects.
And can you tell us a little bit about those personal projects, or are they top secret right now?
Oh, there's nothing secret. It's really just about drawing what I like I did when back in the time where I was not thinking about building a portfolio, because one of the main good thing of landing the job was to realize that I can draw really just for myself now. The portfolio is already built. I already got the job. Now I can just draw whatever I want. I can feel my Instagram page of the same subject matter, and it doesn't matter because I'm not working on a portfolio anymore. I'm not trying to have a versatile portfolio. I really just draw the thing I want to draw. And I really love Studio Ghibli's movie. Mm-hmm. I really enjoy drawing inspired work. I would say my personal project at the moment is to draw simply for fun.
I can see the Studio Ghibli inspirations too, even in your portfolio, with ones like The Green Walk and The Passage, that very
absolutely
the very lush green environments.
These were directly inspired by the movies of Studio Ghibli.
So what is something that you would say is the thing that gets you most excited about concept art and art in general? Is it being able to kind of pull these similar emotions that you're feeling when you talk about art like this out of yourself? Or is it being a part of the process?
Certainly being part of the process, it's a really good feeling, but I think what makes me the most excited about this job is that every minute I spend doing concept art, I get better at it, and it's a skill that I can bring home to be better at my personal projects. I'm always getting better, and it's like a life goal, being super, super, super good, like the person I look at on Instagram and ArtStation, my inspiration. I want to be like them someday, and I think what it feels good about it is that I'm progressing each day, because each day I draw at least 5 hours and I'm paid, I'm living, I'm earning a living. But more than that, I'm also getting better at what I love the most in my life.
You're getting paid to level up in your passion.
Yeah.
That's wonderful. I love looking at it like that.
It's like super productive. That's what I try to say.
Exactly. Would you say that you're someone that has a style with their art? Or do you see yourself as someone that can kind of bounce around to different styles depending on what you're trying to accomplish?
Oh, that's a good question, because I think having a style is something that you won't see by your own eyes. It's something that other people will tell you, oh, I recognize your style. You come, oh, I have a style, I didn't know that. But there's always this moment where you're drawing something completely out of your comfort zone. And I'm talking by experience, because this is exactly what is happening at a job. And your art style, I really like painting, more a painting guy than a line drawing guy. But actually, I have to learn line drawing, because line drawing is just better at some stuff like architecture. You can do it in painting, but in concept art you have to be quite precise. You cannot jump over some details, because the 3D modeler will ask, what is this? It's this place on this building isn't quite defined. So line art is really good at defining everything the 3D artist must know. Painting is really good at doing like big, huge landscape. So being versatile is always the best, especially if you're a concept artist and you could have to draw something completely out of your comfort zone the next day. So be ready for any situation by knowing as many style as you can, because the art direction might be completely the opposite of what you usually draw.
Good. And I guess the last question that I have for you is, what is kind of your main goal, if you have one in mind for the future? Is there something that's really driving you forward at the moment?
Oh, it is quite simple. I'm not even caring about money. I'm really just caring about leveling up. I wanted a concept art job, not just for earning a living, but mainly to have the opportunity to spend most of my days that I would have otherwise spent, yeah, doing work, but drawing. So my life goal is just to be as good as I can. It's like, it's an experimentation. How far can I go? I'm only 21, and when I will be 30, how good will I be? And so on and so on, when I will be 50. It's always about getting better at it, and landing a concept art job is their way, in my opinion, are freelance illustration as well, everything that is art related and earn you a living, let you spend a lot of time drawing, even if it's not for you, it's always a skill that you are enhancing by doing so.
Well, I know I look forward to seeing how you level up in the future more and more as well. Well, and that is all I have for you today. Thank you so much for coming on and sharing all that you have to share with us.
It was a pleasure. Thank you. Thank you for having me.
While I still do you have any platforms or projects that you're currently working on that you'd like to give a quick little shout out to?
Yes, I'm on Instagram, DeviantArt and ArtStation, and Twitter as well, but I think I will quit the platform. I don't know how it works quite well. But yeah, mainly, should I say my username, or it will be linked in the...
We'll definitely be linking those.
Instagram is more for the everyday stuff. ArtStation is for the portfolio stuff. My Instagram is the best place to enjoy my art.
Alrighty. And if anyone is wondering if they can work with you at the moment, how should they contact you, or are you going to pass on that for now? Bit busy at the moment?
Bit busy, but it's always good to leave the door open. So there's my LinkedIn and my email, which I guess will be linked in the description of this video as well.
Yes, definitely. Well, thank you everyone for listening. If you are a concept artist or know one who might be interested in coming on the show, please let me know. And thank you so much for joining us again today, Hugo.
Thank you. It was a good time.
All right. I hope that wasn't too nerve-wracking or anything.
Well, I'm not so proud of my English, but I guess it will do.
Don't worry, you did awesome. And
thank you.
I had a really good time, so I hope that you had a good time.
I had a good time, actually. It was a good English practice, like my friend says.
Hey! It's another way to level up.
Not only drawing, but also speaking.
Exactly!